A life molded by three great souls. A life dedicated to working for the betterment of society. A life lived by uncanny foresight. The life of Kamalnayan Bajaj. If there is a single man who can be credited for the creation of an empire, it would undoubtedly be Kamalnayan Bajaj. A multifaceted personality, Kamalnayan Bajaj preferred to keep his larger-than-life persona out of the limelight. Born to Gandhians, Jamnalal and Janki Devi Bajaj, on 23rd January 1915 at Wardha, Kamalnayan's birth brought immense joy to the Bajaj family, as adoption had been the norm of this wealthy family. From an early age, Kamalnayan was carefree and valiant. Once he accepted a challenge, he would see it through without caring for consequences. The seeds of nationalism were also sown in his mind at a young age. When the Bajaj family answered Mahatma Gandhi's call to renounce and burn foreign-made goods, it was six-year-old Kamalnayan who set the bonfire of foreign clothes ablaze. Once his friends challenged him to jump from the high wall of Bajraj Bhavan in Wardha if he wanted them to adopt Khadi, Kamalnayan didn't think twice before jumping from the 10-foot-high wall. He remained a zealous propagator of Khadi all his life. Kamalnayan's education and training at Vinobaji's ashram laid the real foundation of his character and gave purpose and direction to his life. It was here that he learned the importance of treating all men and all work equal, a quality that stayed on with him. He learned the virtues of honesty and steadfastness from mentor Gandhiji, self-reliance and austerity from Guru Vinoba Bhave, ethics and working for societal welfare from Jamnalal Bajaj. However, Kamalnayan always challenged and questioned their philosophies and would not accept anyone's word till he got a response that resonated within him. When Vinoba told Kamalnayan that he had some weaknesses, his witty student replied, "If I have any weakness, then the responsibility lies on you. You are my guru. There must have been some shortcomings in the way you taught me." After Satyagraha Ashram, his education continued at Gujarat Vidyapeeth, Valji Desai's tutorship in Almora, Jahangir and Kuvabai Vakil's pupil's own school in Pune, and a year under Bernard Aluvihare in Ceylon. In 1936, Kamalnayan's application to Cambridge University was refused due to the lack of prior formal education. Not one to give up so easily, he argued that while other potential candidates would just gain the knowledge and go on, he would help in creating better understanding between the Indians and the British. The principal had no choice but to grant him admission. The constant changing of schools had a deep impact on Kamalnayan's mind. Though externally lively, he always felt a bit lonely, as there had never been enough time in one place to build lasting friendships. Living at the very epicenter of the national struggle for freedom and coming into close contact with its foremost leaders, Kamalnayan imbibed a spirit of burning patriotism. Arrest, imprisonment, fines and confiscation of property were routine occurrences for the Bajaj family. When Gandhiji launched the Salt Satyagraha movement in 1930, 15-year-old Kamalnayan joined the select band of volunteers in the historic Dandi March. One of the many tasks he successfully undertook was mustering the legal defense of freedom fighters, including cousin Radha Krishna, who were implicated in the Wardha, Chimur and Ashti sabotage cases and faced severe penalties including the death sentence. And his role in building the nation continued after independence. In 1947, the Congress Working Committee named Kamalnayan as a member of the state subcommittee and later elected him as the treasurer of the All India States People's Conference in the newly independent India. On behalf of Sardar Vallabhbhai Patel, he played a crucial role in merging the Deccan states with the Union of India. He was elected Member of Parliament for three consecutive terms, where he wholeheartedly rallied for the betterment of the common man. He took active part in the proceedings of the House, particularly on educational, cultural, social, and industrial problems. Despite his political and business assignments, Kamalnayan was a family man. On 30th June 1937, Kamalnayan married Savitri Devi Poddar in a simple ceremony belying the stature of both the families, but in tune with the Bajaj family's adopted life of simplicity. As an independent thinker, Kamalnayan sought an ideal life partner who would prove to be his equal. His desire to have a strong-willed wife was granted in abundant measure. Savitri Devi Bajaj was feisty, unbending, stubborn, and had a persona of her own. As a result, there existed a tension between the couple throughout their conjugal life. As Savitri Devi herself wrote, "This is what happens when two live wires meet." He had the gift of making everyone feel as if they were his chosen one. He paid attention to the needs of every family member, making them feel special in his own way. ...1938 to 1942 was a difficult period for the Bajaj Group. The group's manufacturing businesses were in trouble, and Jamnalal had withdrawn from business activities due to ill health and his desire to concentrate on social work. Kamalnayan abandoned his studies and came back to India to take the reins of the family business. 1942 was a dark year. On 11th February, Jamnalal Bajaj passed away in Wardha at the age of 53. Deeply shaken, the 27-year-old Kamalnayan realized the grave responsibilities he had to shoulder. The political scenario from 1942 to 1972 made the period even more interesting. The freedom struggle, the end of British rule and achievement of independence, the tragedies of partition, and wars with Pakistan and China. It was in this tumultuous period that the Bajaj Group overcame tremendous challenges and rose steadily and relentlessly under Kamalnayan Bajaj. He not only took up the challenging task of reorganizing and expanding his business concerns, but also contributed to the industrial development of the country. He was among the first in the country to enter into foreign collaborations with leading global companies like Philips of Holland and Piaggio and Company of Italy to gain technical expertise. His unconventional decisions were sometimes questioned by detractors, but his ideas always came good in the long run and proved everyone wrong. Under Kamalnayan's chairmanship, Mukund pioneered frugal innovation much before it became a buzzword in the industry. Against advice, he chose to export steel produced by Mukund Iron and Steel despite the huge domestic demand. Years later, when the domestic steel market was hit hard by recession, Mukund was already an internationally established name. He also got into transport and electricity at a time when not many had ventured into those areas. His far-sightedness of demand for cheaper transport and electricity yet again proved to be invaluable to the country. He believed in sharing technical know-how and expertise even with his competitors. Through Bajaj Auto, Mukund, Bajaj Hindustan and Bajaj Electricals, he helped many small entrepreneurs and enterprises set up mini industries. Surely and steadily, he consolidated the various businesses under the umbrella of the Bajaj Group. Kamalnayan's revolutionary business ideas, however, did not override his keen sense of nationalism and humanism. As such, he chose to ignore areas of business which, although profitable, were not in the national interest. He refrained from going into textiles because he was committed to khadi. Even though he owned Hindustan sugar mills, he refused to manufacture potable alcohol from residue molasses because of his stance against consumption of liquor. Kamalnayan successfully built a group of companies based on the concepts of trust, fairness, and honesty and ethics, the values that his father, Jamnalal, had set in motion. The businessman in Kamalnayan never forgot his public responsibilities. Like his father, he believed that businesses did not solely exist for making profits. He extended help to worthy causes like education, medical care, famine, and flood relief. He commemorated Vinoba Bhave's eternal work, the Gitai, by building the unique Gitai Mandir in Wardha, characterized by the absence of roof and deity, to celebrate and pay homage to his guru, Vinoba. Kamalnayan passed away peacefully on 1st May 1972 at Rajbhavan, Ahmedabad, and was cremated on the banks of Sabarmati. Coincidentally, it was here that he had started his education as well as his public life. An eminent son of an illustrious father, an able parliamentarian, an astute businessman, an ardent nationalist, and above all, a man of integrity, Kamalnayan Bajaj's legacy continues to live on.